The development and advance of new technologies have an influence on the everyday life of the human being. The influence can be felt through a better standard of living and a more comfortable life. Human beings themselves have created these new initiatives and innovations. Although many of these innovations utilize natural resources to the maximum benefit, no one knows when these resources will be exhausted and become extinct in the world if we fail to limit our use of the resources of nature and to take care of our ecological environment. In the big cities, where there are high concentrations of people, everyone works hard to maintain their standard of living and their resource consumption is high. Vast amounts of natural resources are used as food for human consumption. This is particularly true of aquatic resources. From the beginning of time, aquatic animals have served as an important source of protein. With the present growth in population, fish consumption in the world will continue to increase. Today, the tuna is among the fish species that are in great demand by consumers. But the number of tuna caught cannot match the demand. New technology has been developed and is used in many countries. The most effective fishing gear for tuna are long line and the purse seine. The richest tuna fishing zones are in tropical waters between the latitudes of 15 degrees north and 15 degrees south. Because the tuna fishing grounds are in the deep seas, the cruise to catch them usually takes many days. To make these long journeys to the fishing grounds safer and more economical, the fishing boats are large, around 500 to 2,000 gross tons. To make these fishing boats more effective, many are fitted with the most modern fishing equipment. An organization with the important role of promoting fisheries development in the Southeast Asian region was set up in accordance with an agreement made by most of the countries in the region. With the name of the Southeast Asian Fisheries Development Center, or SEAFDEC, the organization recognizes the importance of responsible tuna purse seine fishing. Purse seine fishing has less impact on the environment than trawl fishing, and the efficiency of the purse seine makes it worth an investment. Each year, SEAFDEC conducts a number of training courses on fisheries and fisheries-related topics. One of these is a training course on tuna purse seine fishing. SEAFDEC uses its training vessel, MV SEAFDEC, during these courses. MV SEAFDEC is a 1,178 gross ton purse seiner and is equipped with the most modern and sophisticated instrumentation. Among these are radar, side scanning sonar, two-channel echo sounders and satellite global positioning. The purse seine net is 1,156 meters long and 231 meters deep, with a mesh size that allows the smaller fish to slip through. and escape to grow more before being caught. Before the fishing operation starts, thorough detailed planning based on past experience is done. A step-by-step procedure is decided by the master fisherman. After the plan is completed, a study of the fishing ground has been made. The fishing operation will start. Observation of the natural activity of flocks of birds or schools of fish will show where the tuna are to be found. Apart from fish school observation, drifting piaus are used as fish aggregating devices, where small fish gather to feed from the weed that grows on the piaus. The tuna will prey on the small fish and will feed upon them. MV Seafdeck is equipped with radio location devices to find the radio sond buoys attached to the piaus. Before setting a piau adrift, a calculation of current direction and speed will be made to make the location of the piau easier. The target fish like to lie in the shade of the piau, and where there are small fish, very soon the larger fish will come to take them for food. In doing so, the radio direction finder, which is fixed on board, will be used to detect the signal from the radio buoy. The position of the piau will then be found. The population density of the fish around the piaus will be checked using the sideways scanning 360-degree sonar. A workboat, Seafdeck 4, will be launched to assist in the operation using a telesounder. If it is a nighttime operation, the workboat will attach a lure light to the piau to keep the fish in position. Careful planning by the master fisherman ensures that all the equipment to be used is prepared and ready. Only good teamwork by the crew can make this possible. The sonar is used for inspecting the school of fish once again in early morning. The distance between the vessel and the piau is around 1,000 to 1,500 meters. When the sonar confirms a good number of fish, the purse seine net is prepared for shooting. This is a complex operation which requires good seamanship, and every crew member must know his job. All three workboats, Seafdeck 2, 3 and 4, will be used in the fishing operation to assist in the handling of the net. Seafdeck 4 will be used as a light boat with a 2,000 watt light 10 meters below the surface. This light will help keep the fish in position. While Seafdeck boat 3 acts as a backup to Seafdeck 4, her duty is to check the thermocline layer depth with an XBT, expendable bathy thermograph, to check the fish school depth. When everything is prepared, the master fisherman will order the shooting of the net. The skiff boat, Seafdeck 2, will be launched to assist in pulling the net from the stern deck. MV Seafdeck will cruise around the net in a clockwise direction at a speed of 7 to 10 knots until the circle of the net is completed. The purse rope will then be released by the skiff boat to the foredeck of Seafdeck. The winch on Seafdeck starts hauling in the purse line. The skiff boat will then move to the left side of the vessel to assist with balancing during operation. Safedeck 3 will tow the Payal so that it remains in the middle of the enclosing net, while Safedeck 4 will move back and forth to drive in the fish school. The 75 purse rings will be hauled up out of the water to close the net. The rings are kept on the stripper. The workboats will then tow the Payal out of the way. The purse net will be hauled over the stern of the ship using the power block. The workboats will assist by keeping the net clear of the ship's propeller. As the block hauls the net aboard, it is properly arranged on the deck, with the rings in their place and the buoy on the port side. The operation of the net retrieval is under the complete control of the master fisherman. He is there to solve any problems before they arise. With most of the net aboard, Safedeck 2 will keep the net mouth shape, which forms a fish container. Safedeck 3 and 4 will also assist in this work. The fish are lifted aboard MV Safedeck using a large scoop net. The fish then go to the freezer room. Some of the fish will be studied for type, weight, length, and general condition. These studies will be recorded. The fish are placed in a brine solution at 7-fold saltiness. And will be kept in the freezer for at least 24 hours at minus 15 degrees centigrade to minus 18 degrees centigrade. After the fishing operation is complete, the gear will be checked and put in its proper place, ready for the next operation. All the workboats will be lifted back aboard Safedeck. The tuna will be preserved in excellent condition at minus 40 degrees centigrade before going to the fish processing factory or the market. The fish are kept in good condition to command a good price, and the consumer also gets the value in a highly nutritious food. CEFDEC recognizes that the fishery resources of the world must be treated responsibly and tries in its training to develop the fishery's potential for the benefit of the countries in the region.